to this India Today special, the Lok Niti CSDS battle for Bihar opinion poll, a centimeter that is giving us a sense of what is happening on the ground in the first big election of 2020, the first election also being fought under COVID protocols.
What we're about to show you is the vote share and seat share projection done by Lok Niti CSDS for the state of Bihar. But before that, I want you to think about something very carefully. This poll suggests, Rajdeep, that one in four respondents in Bihar at this moment are undecided or they can change their mind. 10% of the respondents said they hadn't made up any mind, and 14% voted for some party in this poll but said last moment pe hum badal bhi sakte, which means that one in four respondents have told CSDS Lok Niti that they could change their mind. With that, let's now show you the overall vote share and seat share numbers according to the CSDS Lok Niti poll.
That's right. Remember, there are 243 seats in Bihar. What is the projected seat vote share first? The Lok Niti CSDS pre-poll survey, NDA, which is the basically the BJP, JDU, of course, smaller parties like the Vikasshil Insan Party, 38%. 38% to the NDA is as per our poll survey. The Mahagathbandhan gets 32%. Projected vote share is 32%. The GDSF, the smaller parties that have come together, 7% is what they are getting at the moment. The LJP, fighting this election on its own in about 143 seats, is getting 6%. Others, which is a substantial number. Remember, a large number of smaller parties have come together. Asauddin Owaisi, Pappu Yadav, Chandrasekhar, Mayawati, all fighting, are getting 17% at the moment. So a 6% gap between the NDA and the Mahagathbandhan is what we are predicting. How is this transferring into seats? That's the big number that you want to know, really. What is happening in terms of seats if elections are held in Bihar today? Remember, the polling starts next week. Projected seat share, Lok Niti CSDS pre-poll. NDA 133 to 143. Halfway mark is 122. NDA 133 to 143, so above the halfway mark, but not getting a two-thirds majority that many have been projecting. 133 to 143, just above the halfway mark of 122. The Mahagathbandhan, 88 to 98. So just short of the three-figure mark. And remember, this includes the left parties as well, which are part of the RJD, Congress, left parties, Mahagathbandhan. LJP is 2 to 6. So Chirag Paswan, as per our poll, remains in single digits, not making much of an impact. Others, and this could include parties from Upendra Kushwaha's party to Asauddin Owaisi to Pappu Yadav, are 6 to 10 at the moment. So, as of now, Rahul, we are predicting, as per the CSDS Lok Niti poll, today the NDA has the edge, but not a substantial edge, not a sweep at the moment.
Let's do a deep dive into the vote share and seat share numbers according to this Lok Niti CSDS opinion poll. If you look at how the vote shares are moving, and if you combine all these parties between 2015 and now, and I'll take the vote share data first, the NDA vote share is at 38%, which includes Jiten Ram Majhi's Hindustan Awam Morcha, Mukesh Sahni's Vikasshil Insan Party, the VIP. There's a 6% gap according to this poll. But what is very significant is the fact that the GDSF, the Grand Democratic Secular Front, which has the Rashtriya Lok Samta Party, the RLSP of Upendra Kushwaha, it has Mayawati's BSP, it has Asauddin Owaisi's AIMIM, is taking away 7% of the vote. If these small parties, which are now a separate opposition front, were somehow part of the opposition, 32 plus 7 is 39, which would have been more than the 38% that the NDA is getting. So that 7% split vote in the opposition, because the opposition is not united, you've got 6% vote going to the Lok Jan Shakti party, you've got 7% vote going to this disparate alliance of the AIMIM, the BSP and the RLSP primarily, you've got a situation emerging where the NDA has a 6% gap. It's a comfortable gap at this moment. helped by the fact that the opposition is split. Let's now show you voting intention and look at the seat share numbers. Remember, the magic mark in the 243-seat assembly of Bihar is 122. Out of this, the Gathbandhan is projected to get 88 to 98 seats. This poll suggests, and the ground reports that we're getting from our reporters on the field suggest, that the strike rate of the Bharatiya Janata Party is expected to be higher and better than the strike rate of the Janata Dal United, especially on seats where you've got the Lok Jan Shakti Party putting up strong upper caste candidates. They seem to be damaging the prospects of the JDU candidates. So you could end up with a situation where the BJP emerges as the single largest party, the JDU coming in at number two. That's the projection according to this poll. And even though the GDSF is not bagging too many seats, taking away 7% of what is clearly an anti-incumbency, anti-government vote is definitely helping the prospects of the NDA in this election.
Absolutely, Rahul. You know, it's unfair in a way to compare 2015 to 2020 because, of course, the alliances have dramatically changed in 5 years. Then the Mahagathbandhan was a real Mahagathbandhan. It included Nitish Lalu and the Congress. Now Nitish is, of course, with the NDA. But let's get first reactions, because clearly what we are projecting is an NDA victory, but not the kind of overwhelming victory that the NDA was hoping for based on how well it did in 2019. Remember, when it won 39 of the 40 Lok Sabha seats. So clearly what we are seeing is a reflection of some element of anti-incumbency, but as per our poll, not enough to actually result in a change in guard in Patna. Swapan Dasgupta, your first reactions to these poll numbers that seem to be suggesting that it is advantage NDA, but clearly not the kind of decisive advantage at the moment that maybe the NDA would have hoped for.
There are two or three qualifications I'd like to make. Firstly, the first issue is about the turnout. I think this is the first election which is going to happen in a COVID situation. So we've got to be very, very careful, and we've got to be very watchful about what is the quantum of turnout. If we are assuming that it's going to be a normal turnout, that may not happen. And if that doesn't happen, who does it favor? That's a question mark. Secondly, the question which really arises is that there is still a large degree of undecided voters, perhaps a disproportionately large numbers. Where will they go? Third, the following of both the Upendra Kushwaha alliance as well as the Lok Jan Shakti party seems a bit, I think you cannot say that these are basically going to endure till polling day. We'll have to see that. And if it doesn't, who does it benefit? So having put in these caveats and qualifications, I would say that what we are seeing is an election where there is a tilt, a decisive tilt in favor of the NDA at present. Now, by logic, In such situations, when a particular party goes into the last 3-4 days of an election with an advantage, that advantage further consolidates. That's the nature of the dynamics of the poll.
Sure.
So I expect perhaps the NDA to consolidate the figures you've given today, and perhaps add to that somewhat. Let's look at the turnout.
Sure. I concede that turnout could be a critical factor. Dr. Sandeep Shastri, since you are associated with Lok Niti, you want to justify your numbers. Do you believe, as Swapan Dasgupta suggests, that these numbers give a decisive edge to the NDA? Would you call it decisive? Or do you believe that given that even a couple of percent either way now could make a difference, this poll suggests that we are in for a closer fight than we anticipated?
Rajdeep, given the situation when the survey was done, it clearly shows an advantage for the NDA-led alliance. And I think prior to the start of formal campaign, if there is a 6 percentage point lead that an alliance has, it makes for a very, very critical advantage. And I think this data, Rajdeep, also goes to summarize some of the debates we have had. Nitish is on the back foot. Yes, his popularity is less. However, the support of BJP, support of the hardcore BJP voters, given the fact that the BJP is the major player in the NDA, and they have conceded that we have projected Nitish Kumar as the chief minister. You bring all those factors together. Though the government does not have the type of popularity it had 5 to 6 years ago, the state government, I mean, I think it's in that context that the data shows that it's not a huge majority that seems to be projected, but just above the 50% mark, given all the factors that we have discussed as part of today's
right.
But you know what I'm poll. Most
let me make one more point
in, yes.
Flowing from this poll, Rajdeep.
Yes, go ahead.
I just wanted to make one more point. I think the campaign is about to begin, and you will have the leaders coming out in the campaign, and I think the hope of the NDA would be that the Prime Minister would be critical in swinging more votes in their favor. On the other hand, I think the Mahagathbandhan would see that its leadership at the state level, which is critical, would play a major role in bringing the alliance more votes. So I think that will be a critical factor in terms of the campaign. We have not seen Nitish campaigning. We are likely to see the Prime Minister campaigning. The Mahagathbandhan leadership is active in the campaign. I think all these factors will play out as you see the next 3 weeks unfold.
Okay. Rahul Verma, 24% of the respondents undecided in some way. 10% saying we haven't made up our mind. 14% gave Loknithi CST as a response, but said we are 50-50, could change our mind on polling day. That's 1 in 4 respondents saying they are ambivalent, they are confused, they haven't made up their mind. Is that abnormally high, or is that rather usual at this stage of the campaign? And which way are these undecided voters likely to sway? Rahul.
So this is a, thank you, Rahul. This is a pretty usual number which you see in most state elections in India, where 1 in 4 voters remains undecided. Undecided voters tend to basically go with what we call as hawa or mahol. So if the election starts sort of like gaining momentum for one particular alliance, the undecided are more likely to shift in that side. And what we might also see, which Swapanji was pointing out, that apart from undecided, even the smaller parties will shrink. So today, LJP might be estimated at 6%, and OLC alliance might be estimated at 7%. Those will also shrink, and they will go towards one side. Now, whether it is going to be NDA, given they already have a critical edge, plus if they manage to sort out the confusion, if that happens, you might see a much, much bigger lead for the NDA.
Okay, Gaurav Bhatia of the BJP joins us. Gaurav, this poll suggests that while the NDA is at this moment well poised to form the next government, there is growing dissatisfaction amongst core BJP voters about who should be next CM. In 2010, 90% of the BJP voters wanted Nitish Kumar as chief minister. Loknithi CST is telling us that that figure is now down to 55. You are in pole position, but your party's own voters are not as enthusiastic about Nitish Kumar as they've been in past elections. How do you deal with this, Conrad?
Okay, so Rahul, first of all, I think even going by the numbers that our channel is showing, the government is formed by the NDA.
And it is by quite a margin in terms of seat as well. A panelist was talking about the vote percentage margin, it was 6%. And the number of seats, even a conservative estimate, is 10 or 11 seats more than the majority number mark that is required in Bihar. So I think it is clear that we are having an advantageous position. When the elections will come close, and when Narendra Modi ji and Nadda ji and other senior BJP leaders will go and campaign, we are very sure that people of Bihar will repose their faith in us. Second, even the people of Bihar understand that they might be undecided today, but they will never go for a party that is in a confused state of mind, like RJD. They are not even sure whether to place the picture of Lalu Prasad Yadav or not. Congress, is a party which is not in a dominant position. It is ready to contest the number of seats given by the RJD, the major player. Whereas, what is the NDA offering? A better coordination between the central government and the state government, which is the key to development. And that is how Bihar politics has changed in the last 15 years. And majority of the years, JDU has been with the BJP. Therefore, we are very optimistic that we will at least get 2/3 majority in the forthcoming
election. This poll, of course, doesn't show you getting a 2/3 majority. So you're significantly down compared to 2019 general election. But no, it doesn't. I have to go by the poll numbers, sir. I have to go by the poll.
The government is still asked, can you dispute that?
Of course, sir. Sir, I'm
not. All that I'm saying is I respect your numbers, but I disagree with it.
Okay. Rohan Gupta of the Congress joins us. Rohan Gupta, you know, the first part of the program, we were looking at largely how Nitish's popularity has gone down significantly, and there is an element of anti-incumbency. But as the big numbers are showing, you're not able to capitalize on that. There's a sense that the opposition has not fully got its act together to capitalize on the anti-incumbency, and that might explain the 40-seat gap, a 30-40-seat gap at the moment between the Mahagathbandhan and the NDA.
This election and betrayal of trust
in this current government. People are not going to forget what has happened during the lockdown or the COVID period. People are not going to forget what has happened to migrant labor. I was in Bihar for the last 7 days, and on ground, the people's dissatisfaction is at a different level. There is 46% of unemployment. You ask any youth there, unemployment is the biggest issue. And Rajdeep, whatever analysis he makes sitting in studios, if you see anger of people and your poll shows large number of people who have not decided yet, I see a strong dissatisfaction against the current government, whether it is Nitish Kumar or Modi ji. BJP spokesperson was talking about Modi ji. There is a strong dissatisfaction against BJP because they haven't got anything. One important more thing, they are caught in the Bermuda Triangle. The people of Bihar, they are not going to be trapped in this Bermuda Triangle of JDU, BJP and LJP. Look what they are doing. LJP is in Modi government but not fighting in the alliance. JDU, which is not there in Modi government, but fighting the alliance. People of Bihar, they are smart enough to understand this practice of BJP and the alliance. They are they are not going to give them the chance.
So it's interesting. The BJP claims momentum. The Congress or the Mahagathbandhan claims an undercurrent. Let's get more reactions to that. Undercurrent versus momentum. Javed Ansari, you want to respond to that? Do you sense in these numbers a much closer fight than perhaps we thought was possible? Or do you believe that once Mr. Modi enters the campaign, 12 rallies with Nitish Kumar, the momentum will defeat the undercurrent?
Look, Rajdeep, if past elections are to go by, we've seen, and Delhi is a glaring example, that where Mr. Modi is not a candidate, his ability to do to actually deliver a state becomes all that more difficult. There is absolutely no denying the fact he's the tallest leader in the country and a big draw. But even he and Mr. Shah combined have not been able to deliver states. They weren't able to deliver Jharkhand. They were unable to deliver. Delhi. And the Lok Niti CSDS poll also says that that a lot of BJP and LJP and JDU voters believe that they only voted for the BJP NDA last time because Mr. Modi was the candidate. You know, in polls, there are two things. Yes, arithmetic is critical, but so is the chemistry. And if you listen to what your own, I've been following what our reporters have been saying, the India Today reporters from the ground, the anecdotal evidence points to something else, that it is not a done deal. In the first program that we did 2 weeks ago, all of us, including myself, felt that it was a done deal. But it's not a done deal.
Okay, so you're saying it's not a done deal. Rajat Sethi? Sethi, you want to respond? Do you think it's a done deal? Well, or do you believe that this kind of verdict, pre-poll, suggests that this is a tough contest?
See, I came to your show a couple of weeks back and I said it was a done deal and it was almost like a walkover that MGB was giving to the NDA. But this verdict, that at least this opinion poll is showing, clearly makes us, you know, think deeper as to how fierce is the anger against Nitish Kumar. There is something very, very special about a Bihari voter. When surveyors like us, when we go on the ground and interact with the Bihari voter, they are exceptionally smart. very politically aware, and they are generally quiet about their political choice. In fact, they will say that we are undecided, or even they will go to the extent of saying that, why should I tell you? So Bihari voter doesn't easily reveal what kind of a political choice he or she is going to make. And this is why you see an exceptionally large number of undecided voters. But I certainly believe if I were to define momentum in the way that who was far behind and who is rushing with the highest speed, I would say that MGB has the momentum, but the center of gravity lies with the NDA. NDA is clearly ahead.
This is very clear. It will be about who can get the hawa behind him. And I want Swapan Das Gupta to answer the question that he posed. He said, turnout will be important, whether it's the US presidential election or the Indian election, which happens around the same time. Indeed, in the middle of a pandemic, turnout is important. On the one side, you've got the superior organizational machinery of the BJP, their ability to pull voters to the booth. The other reality is that a lot of the upper caste, more affluent voters of the BJP are the ones most likely to be most aware of the fear of the pandemic and stay back home. And in any case, the poll seems to suggest they aren't very enthused about Nitish Kumar coming back to power once again. You've got
the last point, Rahul, is critical. How enthused is that BJP voter in a constituency where, let's say, there's a JDU candidate to go out and vote for him?
And the RJD voter, in any case, will go out en masse to vote for RJD and the Mahagathbandhan in the way that he can, because the Muslim Yadav vote bank in this poll is strong. So Swapan Das Gupta, please try and answer the question that you posed. If voting percentages in Bihar were to take a hit, and they're very likely to because we're in the middle of a pandemic, who does it benefit, who does it hurt?
See, firstly, when we come to the question of turnout, I think what's going to be very crucial is to find out what is the extent of a reduction in turnout of elderly 50 plus age group voters. What impact does that have on the outcome? That's a question which we need to take. Secondly, as far as the muted enthusiasm of the BJP voter is concerned, I think you must realize that BJP voter may be muted in its enthusiasm for Nitish Kumar, but I think they are quite petrified of a return to Lalu Guru. I mean, what they consider the Mahagathbandhan type of. So that negativism, more than anything else, despite all the misgivings they may have over Nitish Kumar, they will go out and vote against RJD. That's, I think, quite thing. And I think in the next, the last stages of the election, you will naturally find that there is a concerted attempt to galvanize the faithful. That's always what the last round of elections is always about.
Your point, well,
how do we firm up the faithful?
You know what?
And
what,
that getting the faithful out is very important, because their mood becomes infectious in the larger population. That's the sort of mechanics of election.
Your point is well taken, Mr. Das Gupta, but what is clear at the moment is that there is no wave. You see, in 2019, we saw clear wave.
I'm sick. Rajdeep, every election from 2014, you've said the same thing.
No, 1 minute, we 1 minute. Swapan, yes, my friend.
And we only
Swapan,
assess,
Swapan,
we
give
only
me half a second. My friend, give
let
me half a second. I'm only
words,
going by the numbers,
sir. We can only discover waves in hindsight.
Sir, I agree.
These things we always Swapan, say, there's confusion, yeah, war, no wave. Yeah.
Swapan,
every election,
Swapan,
even
we
like,
had a,
you
we
go
had,
back to the archives, you'll find 1984, the journalists were
sure.
saying the same.
See, my point
so,
is...
So this is, a, this is something which is...
Swapan, look at the number of... I have to go by the poll. The poll shows a large number of undecided voters, larger than normal. Larger than normal. Remember, in 2010, the BJP JDU got more than 200 seats, swept the polls. 2015, the reverse happened. Nitish and Lalu came together, swept the polls. At the moment, as per this pre-poll, there seems no sweep. That's all I'm saying. But I want to ask you this, Manisha Priyam. In Bihar, there are about 50-60 seats where the RJD has their MY factor, the Muslim Yadav factor, work in the favor. They never go below that number because these seats are their firm seats. But there seem no signs of any plus vote to get the incremental vote. The Congress is not, as per the survey, punching above its weight. So is that the advantage, in a sense, that the BJP has, that the BJP perhaps has a better organized cadre on the ground, well mobilized, central government schemes working, and that could make the difference. That the BJP, as per this survey, likely to emerge as party number one of Bihar for the first time in its history.
So that's a position that I've held since the opening show, that BJP is going to do very well. It does have a very well galvanized cadre. But the one important thing that I want to talk about here is the fact that this plus factor that you are talking about for the Mahagathbandhan or the JDU's bad performance or this 24% vote. Now, in the parlance of the Bihari, this has been referred to as the Chuppa vote. Chuppa means the silent voter in English. Now, this Chuppa vote was not a silent non-directional voter. In 2010 and in 2015, the Chuppa voter, I trailed them. These were what were called the Pachphorna castes, the much fragmented EBCs, and they quietly told you that the vote was going to Tir, which meant that they were a consolidated bloc but did not want to talk in front of the more dominant OBCs. Now, the fact is that this time around, this silent Chuppa voter, 24%, has abandoned the directionality towards the Tir, and that's something that is a question mark, therefore. Even for the BJP, this will give them the nightmare, because what we don't understand, that in a few days from now, the first phase of Magad will go to polls. This is the area where the BJP dissidence has come to play at its best. Most of their strong candidates, even from the Agri Jatis, are standing on LJP tickets. And you will find that there will be a one-on-one between a VIP candidate and an LJP candidate. And what I found on the ground is that the Chuppa voter is asking me the question that neither Mukesh Sahni nor the LJP, it's not equal to Mr. Modi. So there is a confusion amongst this 24% or the Chuppa voter. And there's this is what is there, which is up for grabs.
Sure.
Whether
Gaurav Bhatia, Gaurav Bhatia,
you know, the NDA,
for a very long time, it seemed that this election was a done deal, that the NDA would romp home. With LJP breaking away, and Chirag Paswan saying, you know, I'm like Hanuman, tear my chest, you'll find Modi inside me. You know, you managed to create some drama in the election. If LJP, JDU and BJP were together, you know, a lot of the excitement levels would be much lesser. And it almost seems as if, whether it's an attempt to be too clever by half or just the manner in which the dice rolled, some of these things have created confusion, according to this poll, not in the minds of the analysts alone, but in the minds, most importantly, from your perspective, of the BJP's core voter. He doesn't know ki chunav ke baad kya hoga, despite everything that Nadda ji has said, that Amit Shah has said. You've clarified officially, but this poll suggests some extent the BJP voter is confused.
Again, Rahul, I would say the BJP voters are
confused at all. Neither is the party. And it's a done deal that the NDA will form the government in Bihar. And look at the irony that Shri Narendra Modi ji commands such respect that a party leader who is not part of the alliance says, "Main Modi ji ka Hanuman hu." And just today, when Kamal Nath was asked that Rahul Gandhi has shown displeasure over your comment, he said, "Fir kya hota hai?" So people within the party are not respecting Rahul Gandhi in the Congress. And my second point is, somebody was talking about chemistry. Yes, there is a chemistry in the Congress alliance also. Two chemicals are working very hard. One is corruption, which we have seen from Lalu to the Congress Gandhi Parivar. And the second is the dynastic politics that they do. Dynastic politics. What is the NDA offering? Clean image of Nitish Kumar ji, just like Narendra Modi ji offers at the
center. Sir, there are enough sons and daughters of JDU BJP leaders, and there are sons and daughters of Congress RJD leaders contesting.
Just stay
so
with us.
I want
to go across now to one of the most important leaders of the BJP from the state of Bihar, member of parliament, union minister, and one of the senior most ministers in the NDA government, Ravi Shankar Prasad, who's camped out of Patna, now joins us live and exclusive on this broadcast. Mr. Prasad, welcome. The CSDS Lok Niti poll seems to suggest that the NDA will be over the hump, 133 plus seats projected for the NDA, but it also suggests that at the time this poll was done, there was some level of confusion in core BJP voters who weren't as enthusiastic about wanting Nitish Kumar as chief minister as they have been in previous elections. What do you make of the key findings, sir?
Well, I was in your sister channel in Hindi, and I was given to understand, I hope the same is your stand too, that this survey was done in between 10th of October till 15th of October. And this margin was given that it may change for the better for NDA or even otherwise. Therefore, even the authors of this report have lodged that caveat. I am campaigning in my state for the last more than 8 days, campaigning all over the state. This whole day I was campaigning in my constituency in Phatua, visiting villages after villages. Tomorrow I am spending another day in my constituency in Bakhtiarpur. I am also seeing the mood. And today I visited some of those areas which were no-go area. Just to give you one example, Rahul. Yesterday I had was campaigning in Barhi area of Khajauli constituency in Madhubani, just adjacent to Nepal border, 25 kilometers away. When my helicopter was landing, my candidate said, it was a huge crowd of nearly 10,000 people. My candidate said, sir, this was a no-go area for us. After a long time, a BJP leader has landed in the BJP's helicopter. I hope you understand what I'm trying to convey. And the sheer enthusiasm, the welcome, the kind of delivery which Narendra Modi government, Nitish Kumar government has done, is now resonating on the ground. That I would like to say, and that is the reason that even after close to 2005 in the third term plus, this kind of response has come. It is going to concretize. We are campaigning very effectively. And once the Prime Minister comes and addresses the 12th meeting, then you see the decisive shift all the more.
But are you concerned, Mr. Prasad, that amongst NDA voters, when they were asked, why is it that you're voting for the NDA, 16% said Nitish Kumar's government, 27% said because of the Modi government. Even though this is a state election, the dependence on the Prime Minister and the dependence on the BJP is significantly high for the NDA bloc. Nitish Kumar, this poll suggests, is a diminished version of his former Teflon Sushasan Babu self. He doesn't have the kind of pan-Bihar resonance. It's the BJP that's pulling the NDA, emerging likely as the single largest party, with the Nitish bandwagon just tagging along with the BJP engine.
Rahul, I think you have used rather hard words for Nitish Kumar. That will be very unfair. As a chief minister, I know him from my JP movement days. He's my senior. He has performed very well. He's an epitome of integrity and good governance. But yes, what is your problem if my BJP supporters also are keen to support Nitish Kumar because they have greater trust in Narendra Modi government? We are together. My Prime Minister always tells us in our government, Bihar ki khub chinta karo, bina Bihar ke vikas ke desh ka vikas nahi hoga. North East ki chinta karo, bina North East ke vikas ke desh ka vikas nahi hoga. That is his commitment. And you come and see. Yesterday I asked in a meeting in Sikti, in Araria, again near Nepal border, how much time it takes for you to go to Patna by car? They say 5 hours. I asked earlier, 10 hours. Today all the Bihar villages have electricity. They have got roads, and now we are bringing optical fiber connectivity to all the 45,000 villages in the first instance in the coming six months. You have to see Ganga, River Ganga, Rahul, and only two bridges, Mokama and Patna. Now two have come up, about five are coming more. Koshi River, other river, electricity connection, digital connection, physical connection, road connection. People have seen. It was illusory in the 15 years of the government you are trying to claim the leader, seeking to portray himself. And by the way, on a lighter vein, Rahul, I hope you come to Patna. There is a Veer Chand Patel path on which there is a BJP headquarter, there is the JDU headquarter, and then there is the RJD headquarter. The RJD headquarters' big banner has only Tejaswi Babu's image, not the father or the mother, who ruled for 15 years. Why? Why you are apprehensive about your own legacy? Because you are also sure once that legacy comes, the entire legacy of loot, of kidnapping, of corruption, stinking corruption, and complete sense of lawlessness will come about. That's how the Bihar election is
called for. But Mr. Prasad, is it a two-thirds?
That's what I would like to comment.
Mr. Prasad, just one question. Most opinion polls have put BJP at 160 plus or NDA at 160 plus. Our poll is putting 135 to 145. Are you still looking at, in 2019, you led in 223 segments out of 243. Do you see a diminishing compared to 2019, or do you believe that as time goes on, the equation will change further?
Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai, since morning Rahul Kamal was chasing me. Finally, I agreed. I'm in a hectic campaign since morning. Now, you also chip in. All right, that's your right.
No, your number, sir. I wanted your number.
You keep on these calculations, Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai.
I wanted your number.
We calculate on the ground. Calculate on the ground. It will be a convincing majority of nearly two-thirds. Number I will give you, let the whole thing go on. I am telling you it will be a two-thirds majority clearly. And you are yourself saying, even your conservative estimate, which you are trying to project, gives us a clear majority. More than that, if that is what you are giving, it is going to be a surge forward only, more and more.
Mr. Prasad, we saw Chirag Paswan say, We saw Chirag Paswan say, I'm Hanuman, open my chest, you'll find the image of Narendra Modi. We've seen your party president, we've seen the Home Minister, Amit Shah Ji, come out and say that we are strongly backing Nitish Kumar and that there is no question of any change. But this poll suggests amongst BJP voters, at the time when this poll was done, there was some confusion. Are you confident that you've been able to convince BJP voters fully, or are you apprehensive that where there is a JDU candidate up against maybe a rebel from the BJP, an upper caste candidate on an LJP seat, that there could be problems that you'd need to deal with, Mr. Prasad? How do you hope to deal with that?
First of all, I'm happy you are repeatedly lodging the caveat during the time this polling survey was conducted. Always keep that in mind. Yes. The issue of Chirag Paswanji has already explained by Home Minister, by the party president, here the in-charge Devendra Fadnavis, Sushil Modi, Bhupen Yadav, myself repeatedly. Ram Vilas Ji was a towering leader. His death is painful. Would have loved to see that Chirag Paswanji remains with us. He did not. He chose to decide his own course in Bihar. The detail have been explained by Amit Shah Ji and J.P. Nadda Ji, who were privy to these negotiations. The matter ends there. The Bihar NDA comprises JDU, BJP, Jitan Ram Manjhi's Hum Party, and very clearly Mukesh Sahni's Vikashil Insan Party. Strong, united. Our workers have no confusion. I will not deny initially there may have been some, in some constituency. But now it is very clear, the message has gone. And the Prime Minister is going to campaign for 23rd. He is going to address 12 meetings. There will be no scope for any ambiguity or confusion. And by the way, just don't forget you asked JDU campaigning BJP. Rahul, हमारे रिश्ते 1995 के हैं. इस बात को आप कृपया कभी ना भूलें. बिहार की बीजेपी जमीन पर और नीतीश कुमार की जेडीयू पहले समता पार्टी की पार्टी जमीन पर हम एक दूसरे को समझते हैं, पहचानते हैं और ट्रस्ट करते हैं. Never forget that.
So you don't see, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, any possibility of a repeat of Maharashtra, some kind of a super over, that after the election some change takes place?
Rajdeep, I think you will have some separate moments with me, isn't it?
I'm coming to Patna in a few months.
We are very emphatic. Whosoever get what? I know you will have Golgappas on the Fraser Roads and charts, which are your favorite during campaign.
Absolutely.
Go and enjoy the good snacks of Patna. Good luck to you. I'm only saying whatever are the numbers, our assurance, our understanding and our pledge is very clear. Nitish Ji will be the Chief Minister.
That's very clear.
We leave it over there. Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, all the best for the rest of the campaign. You've got 1 week to go before the first phase starts. Thank you so much for joining us on this opinion poll discussion. We've got Ajay Alok of the Janata Dal United with us. And the problem for the JDU is that Nitish Kumar's popularity has come down. The dissatisfaction level amongst voters in Bihar seems to be going up. While the central government remains popular, this is not the Nitish Kumar that we've seen over the past 15 years. This is a diminished version of the Teflon Sushasan Babu self.
Well, these kind of dialogues I'm quite pretty used to, because I used to listen to these kind of comments in 2015 also. And nothing was new in 2020. So I'll wait for 10th November. With all due respect to your survey, I still believe that the people of Bihar have reposed their faith again and again, and they will do it again in the coming elections. Don't forget, when you were conducting the surveys, it was between 10th of October to 17th of October. At that point of time, there were many ticket seekers. Many were those who were denied the tickets. Many were those who went to LJP. LJP broke off with the NDA. They went separately. Ram Vilas Ji's death. All these things combined together.
But Ajay Alok, this is a centimeter that is weighing public sentiment. If there is any worry that you should have, the top issue as per our survey, along with development, is unemployment. And when I look at Nitish government's performance as per the Lok Niti CSDS pre-poll, it's your highest failure is rated among those in the age group 18 to 25. 69% in this age group are saying your government has been a failure. Now, this is a generation that has not seen Lalu Raj. These are all people who are born after 2000, the millennials. Are you worried that the younger Bihari is slowly distancing itself, particularly from the JDU? Is that a concern? Because clearly all our numbers are pointing out to Nitish Kumar's popularity coming down substantially.
Well, I don't think so, because there's a reason attached to it. Number one, whatever the numbers of the unemployment are there, it's there for the whole country, except in the month of April when the COVID started, that the Bihar was ranked at 46.6%, just behind Tamil Nadu and one other, Bumo state. But now it has come down significantly to 12.2% as per the CIDE survey. See, Nitish Kumar, it's not a matter of those people who have not seen Lalu Raj. Their parents have seen, their relatives have seen, and everyone has seen. This is a matter of expectation, Rajdeep. In the last 15 years, Bihar has seen unprecedented development. There's a tectonical shift in the people thinking about development. Earlier, I was living in Patna in 2000. My home generator used to run around 16 to 17 hours a day. And I had no complaints in 2000, you know, because that was the norm. How can I expect electricity for 20 hours or 21 hours? So it was a norm that 8 to 9 hours electricity in Patna, it's fine. Rest in Bihar, no place, no electricity, nobody used to bother. Today, with electricity, nearly almost 22 to 23 hours everywhere in Bihar, roads connectivity improved dramatically. Living conditions has improved.
Can I for a moment take what you're saying, which is an interesting point, that you believe expectations have been raised by Nitish to the Congress? Rohan Gupta, if you're still with us, give us a sense. Do you concede that your, as is being pointed out, Lalu Prasad is not even on some of the posters? Is there a fear that the moment you bring Lalu Prasad on any poster, people are reminded of his period? While he has his strong Muslim Yadav alliance intact, clearly the BJP, JDU wants to compare their rule with Lalu's rule. Are you ready for an open comparison between your rule and Lalu's rule? Sorry, Lalu's rule and the JDU rule.
First of all, if you see all BJP spokespersons, they are very confident about their win. If they are so confident about their win, why they are bothered about the posters of opposition party? The issue is not that, Rajdi. If you see on ground, and I'm sure when you go to Patna, you realize it, there is a strong dissatisfaction against this government. If you talk about Mr. Nitish Kumar,
metric trust of people in 2015.
Sir, they may be satisfied, but they don't want to vote for the other side. That is the problem. Yes, they may be dissatisfied with the BJP, JDU, but they don't want to vote for a return to what they see could be Yadav Raj.
Let me complete. Bihar mein Jharkhand hone wala. Why I'll tell you. Four elections have happened after Lok Sabha elections. BJP was in power in three of the states. Today, BJP is in power only in one state, and that is not a full majority government in Haryana. See, whatever media propaganda you do, Rajdeep, at the end of the day, people see what they have received.
So it's not propaganda, it's a poll.
Let me complete. Just 1 minute. If you see Bihar in terms of corona period pandemic, Bihar is the worst affected state. Whether it is corona pandemic or the migrants issue, people are not going to forget.
Okay.
You won't forget that 25 lakh people who have left Bihar and come back, they are not going to
so
forget.
So joining us okay. also now this is on this broadcast is the state president of the Bharatiya Janata Party, Sanjay Jaiswal. Mr. Jaiswal, स्वागत है आपका हमारे CSDS लोकनीति ओपिनियन पोल में. जब ये पोल हुआ उस वक्त जो तस्वीर उभर रही है वो ये है कि बीजेपी का जो कोर वोटर है उसमें से केवल 55% ही चाहते हैं कि नीतीश कुमार दोबारा सीएम बने. आपकी सरकार बन रही है ऐसा ये पोल सजेस्ट कर रहा है, लेकिन आप ही के कई वोटर ऐसे हैं जो नहीं चाहते कि नीतीश कुमार दोबारा सीएम बने. 1/3 of the voters actually want a new leader to be CM.
पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष ने और माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने मिलकर के यह निर्णय लिया है कि हम यह पूरा चुनाव नीतीश कुमार जी के नेतृत्व में लड़ेंगे. और नीतीश कुमार जी 15 वर्षों में अच्छा काम किए हैं और राष्ट्रीय नेतृत्व के निर्णय के साथ भारतीय जनता पार्टी के सभी कार्यकर्ता रहते हैं और सभी जो राष्ट्रीय नेतृत्व का निर्णय होता है उसका पालन करते हैं और नीतीश कुमार जी ही हमारे मुख्यमंत्री.
लेकिन जयसवाल जी,
कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं.
जयसवाल जी, अगर नंबर ऐसे आते हैं कि बीजेपी में सबको सबसे ज्यादा नंबर मिलते हैं, आप 111 सीट लड़ रहे हैं, समझ लीजिए आपको 70-80 सीट आते हैं, नीतीश कुमार को 50 सीट आते हैं या 45 सीट आते हैं, क्या उस स्थिति में भी नीतीश कुमार जी ही रहेंगे या एक साल बाद आप बदलाव चाहेंगे, या कहीं डर है कि महाराष्ट्र की तरह नीतीश कुमार कहीं दूसरी तरफ ना जाए अगर आप उनको एक तरह से किनारे कर दे?
भारतीय जनता पार्टी का प्रत्येक कार्यकर्ता अपने राष्ट्रीय नेतृत्व का आदेश मानता है और जब राष्ट्रीय नेतृत्व ने यह तय कर दिया कि नीतीश कुमार हमारे मुख्यमंत्री हैं तो आप विश्वास करिए कि हर
खुशी से खुशी से मान रहा है जयसवाल जी. सॉरी,
पार्टी पूरी शक्ति से लगेगी.
जयसवाल जी, खुशी से मान रहा है या कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है इसलिए मान रहा है?
नहीं, खुशी से मान रहा है. भाजपा में सारे निर्णय सामूहिक होते हैं और जब एक बार पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड के द्वारा कोई सामूहिक निर्णय हो जाता है उसकी बात प्रत्येक कार्यकर्ता बूथ के स्तर पर मानता है और जो भी आज हमारे पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड के मेंबर्स हैं वह सब कभी बूथ स्तर के कार्यकर्ता रहे हैं. हमारे यहाँ कोई फैमिली ट्रेडिशन तो है नहीं कि किसी फैमिली के बेटे होने से कोई पहुंच जाए, तो नेचुरली ये सब कार्यकर्ता के रूप में थे और आज हमारे पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड में हमारे राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष हैं, हमारे प्रधानमंत्री हैं, हमारे गृह मंत्री हैं, तो उन सबों ने यह निर्णय किया है. तो भाजपा, आपका जो भी आकलन हो, मैं भाजपा प्रदेश अध्यक्ष के नाते पूरी गंभीरता से इस बात को कह रहा हूँ कि जदयू का प्रत्येक कैंडिडेट को जिताना भारतीय जनता पार्टी की जिम्मेवारी बनती है और जदयू के सभी कैंडिडेट्स भाजपा के समर्थन और जदयू के समर्थन से जीतेंगे. हमारा जो प्रोपोर्शन है अभी टिकट के वितरण का वही प्रोपोर्शन रहेगा जीत का.
थैंक यू वेरी मच संजय जायसवाल जी फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस. आई थिंक दिस इशू विल बी की. We've seen though, Rajdeep, in places like Surat in Gujarat, where there was disaffection amongst BJP voters initially and it kept coming up during the during ground reports and during opinion polls. But in the end, the point that Sanjay Jaiswal makes, that we're a disciplined party, they may crib, but in the end they'll vote for the BJP. The question is, can they fall in line? Will they fall in line? We've seen it happen in the past and that's what the BJP is confident will happen again.
Let me end by throwing a bit of a googly, Rahul. If these numbers are there, it is clear no single party is getting a majority.
But that's impossible.
It's not possible. Agreed. Yeah, yeah. Except for RJD, correct. No one would be in position given the seats. This is the season of the IPL. And the IPL has been, in this season, dominated by super overs. The small possibility exists that if it is fractured, you could have a super over, where everyone then decides post-poll where they are going. As per this poll, that doesn't seem likely.
No, but BJP between 2 and 6, you know, super over also requires a
that's
tie.
Right. So if other parties get more than what we are anticipating, but as of now, super over is a distant possibility like Maharashtra. To my mind, it clearly at the moment suggests momentum is with the BJP, JDU. Undercurrent is anti Nitish. I don't think that with these numbers we can rule that out, that there is an anti-incumbency, anti... Look at the numbers of Nitish Kumar's personal popularity. They are low. A chief minister, normally Rahul gets 60%
plus. But to be able to convert that undercurrent into a victory for the opposition, you need a strong opposition.
Absolutely right.
That's going out blazing on all cylinders, that's got a formidable chief ministerial face. You have to present an alternative to cash in on that that anti-incumbency undercurrent.
And that last mile connectivity. The BJP with its last mile mobilization will have the edge. But as we've seen post-2019, don't rule out the opposition. Haryana was a good example. I think what this poll has done is only increase the excitement.
But that's the thing. What it does is that don't think that this is a done deal and the
it's
election's
not a done
over.
Deal.
You will need to tune in to India Today for the best reportage from the ground. We've got the biggest team of reporters traversing the state of Bihar, capturing the pulse of the people of Bihar. Remember, this is coming in the middle of a pandemic. It's an election of a kind India hasn't seen earlier. In fact, the world hasn't seen earlier. So we'll be tracking this very, very closely. I want to thank all our guests for joining us. We want to thank the team at CSTS Lokneeti for giving us this data, which we put out on India Today, and the work that they did in actually going out and in the middle of a pandemic, speaking to these people and bringing the results together.
The old jungle saying, in Mumbai's Dalal Street, you need a rising Sensex. In Bihar, you need politics to get Biharis going.
Bihar mein kya ba? Politics ba.
That's
whether
right.
Anything else happens or not, the politics
that's right.
is
so
exciting.
We look forward to that. This has been the battle for Bihar. Thanks for watching.
India Today TV, along with 70 other news